Season greetings and welcome to my channel. And for those of you who already know me, I know it's been some time since I uploaded last, but that is how life is. I have made 3 Yule episodes, and one will be published each Sunday, starting with this one. A Yule calendar is something that everyone in Scandinavia knows what is, and by the end of this video, so will you. So sit back and relax, and let's get started. Many of us have had an advent calendar during our childhood, especially here in Denmark. And the advent calendar has become as much a part of Christmas as the Yule stockings or the Christmas tree. But is it a Christian tradition or is it pagan in its origin? The short answer is, it's Christian. The advent calendar is not as old as we might think it is. It has its roots in Germany at the beginning of the 20th century. This was a time when many of the customs we associate with the celebration of Christmas was invented. Today, and more than 100 years later, the advent calendar is still very popular. Lots of people around the world, from Christians to non-Christians, still go out and purchase an advent calendar for either themselves or their children to count down the days until Christmas. One of the first examples of something that could be called an advent calendar comes from a children's book that was published in 1851 by Elise Everdeek in Germany. Every evening, when the little girl Elizabeth goes to bed, her mother tells her a little bit about the origin of Christmas. Afterwards, they sing a lot of Christmas carols together and hang a new picture about Christmas on the wallpaper. They do this until all of the 24 pictures hangs on the wall. And then the children know that Christmas is here. Before the advent calendars were invented, the families would simply use chalk marks on the doors and wipe one away every day to count down the days. The first calendars were actually not even called an advent calendar, but they were called Nicholas calendars. Because they were distributed on December 6, which is on St. Nicholas Day. At this day, a guy would dress up as St. Nicholas and hand out Nicholas calendars to the children. The first and oldest printed advent calendar was published in 1902, and it is actually not even a calendar, but it was a clock with 12 numbers on it, and a pointer that you could move to count down the 12 days of Christmas. However, this is a very debated topic, and the opinions about if it even should be called an advent calendar are split down the middle. Nevertheless, it was a German named Gerhard Lang who has officially been credited for being the inventor of the first one. And it all started when he was just a little boy. When Gerhard was just a little boy, his mother gave him 24 cookies that were sewn onto a lid and put on a piece of cardboard. He was allowed to eat one cookie every day, and thereby counting down the days until Christmas Eve. In 1903, when Gerhard was in his early 20s, he remembered this homemade advent calendar by his mother, and it probably inspired him to make them. The calendars were mass-produced by the company called Reichhold & Lang, and it was called Im Lande des Christkinds, or in English, In the Land of the Christ Child. The date for when it was published used to be in 1908, but it was later pushed back to 1903. The first one did not have any doors on it. It was only something that was invented almost 20 years later. However, the calendar did have 24 numbers on it, which is the amount of numbers required to call it an advent calendar. and not a St. Nicholas calendar, which only has 19 numbers on it. It had 24 short verses about Christmas and 24 colorful images that were drawn by the artist Richard Ernst Kepler. Every day from the 1st of December to the 24th, a child would carefully cut out one of the images and glue it onto the front of the calendar and thereby hide the short verses one by one. These verses were printed on each side of the calendar, so you could still read them on the back. I think it's interesting that this first version is called a Weihnachtskalender and not an Advent calendar. Weihnachtskalender means, literally translated into English, Christmas calendar. Around the year 1920, the same German company Reichhold & Lang from München, or Munich in English, came up with the idea to make them with small doors that you could open like the ones we know today. The calendar was designed by the artist Dora Baum, and it was given the name Christkindlein's House, or in English, the House of the Christ Child. This calendar only had 19 double doors on it, starting from the 6th of December until the 24th of December, which means the calendar belongs among the St. Nicholas calendars. During the First World War in Europe, the production had pretty much stopped, and it was not until now that the demand for them was beginning to rise again, along with the German economy. Different kinds, with various designs, and in all kinds of sizes and price ranges, began to be sold each year in Germany during the 1920s. They slowly began to be something that a common man could and would purchase for his children. Around the year 1926, the first with chocolate came to the market in Germany. It was again the innovative company Reichhold & Lang who came up with the idea to purchase 20 different pieces of chocolate from the company Stollwerk and put them into the advent calendar for Christmas, called the Christmas Rose. At the beginning of the 1930s, the first for blind children began to be produced in Germany. And the first version was a remake of the calendar in the Land of the Christ Child from 1903. It was also in the 1930s that the demand increased rapidly throughout Germany, along with the economic boom, which has often been described as Germany's economic miracle, as Germany was the first country in the West that started to recover from the Great Depression. However, due to the Second World War, the National Socialist German Workers' Party, also known as the NSDAP, put a ban on the production of the illustrated calendars, except the publisher Franz Eher Verlag, which was controlled by the party. The name was also changed to Pre-Christmas Calendar, and the traditional Christian images were replaced with symbolism and ideological content from the party. After the war, the calendars regained the previous name and the knowledge began to spread to more countries around the world. During the 50s, 60s and 70s, the calendars became more colorful with many more small and beautiful details on them. In Denmark, the advent calendars did not become a thing before at the beginning of the 1930s, where the first two were sold in the local stores. However, they were not called an advent calendar in Denmark, and they still aren't, but they are called a julekalender. The two julekalenders had almost the same name, just without the hyphen, børnenes julekalender, or in English, the children's Yule calendar. However, they were not identical. The first one was a tear-off block calendar with colored drawings and three short verses. The second one is what we today would call a traditional advent calendar with 24 numbers on it. It's a little unique because the tiny boxes are all in different shapes and sizes, and the images behind the numbers are based on the Danish Yule, and not images from southern Germany, which was often seen on most advent calendars outside of Germany. It was not everyone who could afford to purchase one of these. And that led to some people using their creativity to make one themselves. This Yule calendar was handmade in Denmark in 1932, and it was made as a gift for a family member. And the text says, Merry Christmas, or Glædelig Jul in Danish. The stars and the roof of the church are made from glossy paper, and inside the tiny little boxes, there are small images cut out from scrap pictures, or as we call them in Danish, glansbilleder. After the Second World War, advent calendars with small gift-wrapped presents, called a pakkekalender in Danish, slowly began to become the norm in Denmark. An advent calendar with presents would typically have 24 small gifts on it, and one big gift on the 24th of December. The presents could contain small packs of Lego or candy for the children. These calendars with presents are still very popular, especially here in Denmark, and some adults also make an advent calendar for their partner. For a male, this could for instance be 24 beers. However, if you do not want your partner to be drunk all December, then you could simply just give him beers on Sundays. And now that we are talking about Sundays, some families only give advent gifts. So instead of many small gifts, they get four big presents, one each Sunday on Advent. In 1994, the Danish state-owned gambling company called Dansk Tipstjeneste began to sell jule scratch cards, or skrabejulekalender in Danish, where the grand prize was 1 million kroner. One lucky person could have an extra Merry Christmas and be able to buy bigger presents for their loved ones, or just take a long holiday away from all the hassle. Today, these advent calendars are just as popular as they were in the 1930s. But back then, you could only choose between one or two. Today, you can find them in the hundreds, or maybe even in the thousands. From candy to toys to insurance, there's literally all kind of versions that you can think of. If you need a little bit of inspiration on what kind of calendar you should get, you can take a look in the description. In Scandinavia, we have something that is quite unique, and that is the annual Christmas calendar, also known as a Yule calendar. A Yule calendar is like an advent calendar, where you get to open one of the tiny little doors each day to get a present or a treat. But instead of treats, you get to watch one of 24 TV episodes about Christmas, or Yule, as we call it in Scandinavia. The first episode always start on the 1st of December, and the show ends with the grand finale on the 24th of December at Christmas Eve, or as we call it in Denmark, juleaften. Children often sit and watch the final episode, either before or after dinner. But some families also choose to record it for the next day, so they can enjoy the family dinner together. A Yule calendar is mostly a story that has been written for the children. And that is quite obvious, because the children sit glued to the TV every evening when a new episode airs. There are also some for the adults, but many adults still watch the children's Yule calendar anyway. It was in 1960 that the Swedish TV station SVT came up with the idea of making the first TV Yule calendar. 2 years later, the Danes aired their own TV Yule calendar called Historia fra hele verden, stories from all over the world. And soon thereafter, the Norwegians, the Finns, and the Icelandic people would make their own versions. A Yule calendar is often a bunch of small stories or one long story, just like a TV series, where you follow the same characters and their interaction in a story. All the stories are focused around Christmas, and the story often has some familiar figures, such as Santa Claus, or Julemanden, as we call him in Danish, or Santa's Little Helpers. We call Santa's Little Helpers Nisser in Denmark, and in Norway and Sweden they are called Tomte. It's actually wrong to translate them into Santa's Little Helpers, because there are actually house spirits, and they date back thousands and thousands of years to a pre-Christian era in Scandinavia. So these house spirits are actually pagan in their origin. And I would just like to add, you can't translate it into to elves either, because it's a wrong translation. They are called nisser or tomte. A Yule calendar is often about historical events, persons or figures, for instance nisser, where the most important parts are emphasized. Usually some sort of problem that needs to be fixed before the 24th of December. This could, for instance, be saving Christmas, which is a reoccurring theme for these Yule calendars. In Denmark, the concept really began to gain some traction in 1967, when the Yule calendar called Kender du Decemberweg, Do You Know About December Street, was shown on the Danish TV station DR. This one is still one of the favorites for many of the Danes, and the main character, Magnus Taumus, fills their dolls with nostalgia when they watch it. In 1974, another golden nugget was born, called Julerup Færøby, which is one of the great classics. In 1979, the Yule calendar, Jul I Gamleby, was made. It was the first calendar in 17 years that was made with real actors instead of the traditional use of puppets. Jul I Gamleby was also the first where the target group was the entire family and not just the toddlers. The 1980s gave birth to a long list of good Danish Yule calendars. Jul på Slottet, Christmas at the Castle, Nissebanden and Nissebanden in Greenland. It would be translated to something like the Nisse Gang. Personally, Nissebanden are among my own childhood favorites. It was also in the 80s that the production began to become very expensive, and many of the calendars that were aired by the TV station DR in the 80s were shown as reruns in the 90s, instead of making new ones. However, the 90s was also the decade where the Danish TV station TV2 began to produce their own. TV2 wanted to expand their target group, probably for economic gain, and they decided also to produce one for the adults. The first one was called Jul I den gamle trædemølle, and it gained a profound amount of viewers in the first year. However, it would be the calendar called the Yule Calendar that aired in December of 1991 that would quite literally glue the Danish eyeballs to the TV screen like no other had done in the past. This one was actually so good that the Norwegians took great notice of this and copied it into a version of their own. The 1990s was also the decade where the naughty nisse called Pyrus would make his appearance for the first time in the julekalender called Alle Tiders Jul. And this one would turn out to be so popular that it would continue throughout the 90s and turn into a series. In 2005, the first non-Christian Yule calendar was produced, if you can believe it. It was called Jul I Valhall. Jul I Valhall. And the Yule calendar evolved around a group of humans and the Nordic gods. There's been made so many great Yule calendars throughout the years, and most Danes and other people in Scandinavia have at least one or two favorites. In Scandinavia, we also love to see American Christmas movies. For instance, Home Alone, The Polar Express, The Santa Claus, National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, and many, many more. A movie that is not necessarily a Christmas movie for the Americans, but it is to a lot of Danes, is the movie Die Hard, or Die Hard 2, that even has some snow in it. These movies have actually been shown each year around Christmas in Denmark for decades. As much as the Yule calendars are a solid tradition during December, the Disney show From All of Us to All of You is as well. This Christmas special from 1958 is aired every Christmas in the afternoon on the 24th of December, while the children wait in excitement for Christmas Eve. And yes, in Scandinavia, we celebrate Christmas on the 24th and not the 25th as they do in, for instance, the US. If you want to see all the calendars that have been aired in Denmark or in the rest of Scandinavia, you can check out the link in the description. If I don't see you again, I hope that you and your family will have a Merry Christmas, or as we say in Scandinavia, Glædelig Jul, or God Jul.